I have a demonstration of pH buffers, and I'm going to compare a buffer to pure water. And I'm going to start off with four solutions that are at pH 7. They're neutral solutions. The water is mixed with a universal indicator, and a universal indicator is a mixture of indicators that has a color of violet at basic pH. Neutral, it's green, and it's orange at acidic pHs. And the range is about from 11 to 7 to pH 3 for those color changes. I've got hydrochloric acid, 1 molar, with a dropper, and sodium hydroxide, 1 molar, with a dropper, so that we can add just a tiny amount of acid or base to see how it changes the pH. And we're going to observe that pH change by observing the color change. I'm going to start off with the water, and I'm going to add a drop each of acid on the left, on my left, and base on my right. So you can see where they dropped, there's a color change, but I'm going to mix them up by swirling. And you can see that that one drop of acid, one drop of base, has changed the pH of those water solutions significantly, from 7 to around 3, from 7 to around 11. Now we're going to take a look at the buffer. And the buffer is a mixture of acetic acid and ammonia. It has a buffer pH of around 7, and it will buffer against changes in acidity or basicity. So, I'm going to do the same addition of a single drop of acid and base to compare. And see that locally you get a little bit of a change. But once I swirl it up, it's like I didn't change anything at all. Those solutions are both neutral. So now I'm going to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 drops, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 drops, and let's see what happens. So even adding a significant amount of acid and base only changes the pH a little. Now, to my eye, this side is starting to look a little bit yellow, and this side is starting to look a little bit bluish. From, you know, so they're diverging away from the green color that they started, but still, it's taken a whole lot of addition to change those colors. Now, buffers aren't magic. If I add more acid or base than the buffering capacity, then I'm going to be able to get these solutions to change color, change pH. Once I exceed the buffering capacity of these mixtures, then, as you can see on the acid side, I pushed right past it. On the base side, not so much. So what we can look at, though, is these are still buffered, right? If I add a couple of drops of base to the water and a couple of drops of acid to the base and mix them up, then they're still really sensitive to the addition. The hydrochloric acid and the sodium hydroxide form salt. So these are strong acids and a strong acid and a strong base. So they form a neutral conjugate. They form a neutral solution. So I can just push these guys back and forth without a problem. However, if I add SN base to the buffered solution. You can see that they're heading back towards neutral, but the pH doesn't change as much as with the pure water. So this is a demonstration of a buffer and how they resist changes in pH, and of water, pure water, very sensitive to changing pH on addition of a strong acid or a strong base. Thanks for coming to Lecture Hall B in the Science Center, COVID era.